the starting lineup for Iolani first. Starting in the goal for Iolani, number one, Ted Armstrong.
We're not rolling, are we?
Number two, playing in the field. Ed Schatz.
Good afternoon and welcome to Punahou and Iolani Water Polo.
Number three, Kale, Flagg. Number four, Ed Yamada. Number five, Aaron Brown.
Aaron Brown being introduced for Iolani. Welcome to Pono Iolani Water Polo. Yours truly, Dave Rosen at poolside.
Number 10, Pono Faulkner.
Pono Faulkner for the Red Raiders being introduced.
And number 11, Dean Anderson.
Dean Anderson, the big old man for Iolani.
Starting lineup for Iolani. Starting for Punahou. In the goal, number one, Pat Wilkinson.
Pat Wilkinson getting the nod as goalkeeper this afternoon.
Number four, Scott Stevenson.
Scott Stevenson, the quick one.
Number five, Matt Cockett.
Matt Cockett, Mr. Dependability, stepping up to the front.
Number six, Mark Maretzki.
Maretzki, the darting, flashing one.
Number eight, Mike Twigg-Smith.
Mike Twigg-Smith, Twiggy as he's known.
Number 11, Peter Wong.
Peter Wong will be setting this afternoon, most likely.
And number 13, Eddie Weldon.
Edward Big Man Weldon.
Game underway in 1 minute.
So the stage is set here for the final matchup of the 1984 season between Iolani and Pono. Pono has to come in this game somewhat confident after what is to be believed an 11-3 score. Pono on top at Iolani earlier this year. Of course, overt confidence could play a factor in this game if Pono is not careful. Don't count Iolani out of any contest. They're always here. They're always ready to play. And looks like we'll have
a
good ball game this afternoon.
For Iolani, head coach Aaron Chaney.
Aaron Chaney, the coach of Iolani, being introduced.
For Pono, head coach Ken Smith.
Ken Smith, a mainstay in Punahou water polo, brought it to the top and kept it there for a number of years. A few less hairs now than a few years ago, but still every bit as good as a coach. Last minute instructions being given to the players. The Punahou players already lining up.
Today's game marks the second time these two teams have played. In the first game, at the Iolani pool, Punahou won that first match. If Punahou wins today, they will be the ILH champions, having gone through the season undefeated. If the Iolani wins today, it will force a playoff match next week.
Coach Ramsey of Kamehameha giving you the...
Since Ken Smith has been at Punahou when he first came here in 1973.
A lowdown on this evening's game.
Punahou has won the league championship every year except 1982, 2 years ago, when Aaron Chaney and his Iolani team won the league championship. Last year, Punahou won the league championship and regained the title.
The players getting ready to get this underway in here. Quite a large crowd on hand this afternoon. 20,000-30,000, I'm not sure. Coach Chaney looking a bit pensive on the sidelines, wringing his hands, a sign of anticipation here. Referees being introduced.
Sprinting for Punahou, number four, Scott Stevenson. For Iolani, number three. Flagg.
It'll be Stevenson versus Flagg on the ball toss this afternoon, and the game is underway. Clock does not start until the player has touched the ball. Pono easily controlling the sprint. And Pono goes down to set up. Twigg-Smith with the ball. Some faking going outside into the hole to Wong. Excuse me, Cockett. Playing with the ball, looking for open man. Can't find any. Being fouled. That's two fouls in the hole. Three fouls and an ejection. Oh, Eddie's free. Nice stop by the goaltender. Stevenson put it up. Armstrong with the reject. Gets an outlet pass out to the far wing. His man's in trouble. They try to bring it back up on top. That's number two, Schatz with the ball. He throws in the hole for the big man. No one's free. Pono on the steal. Not a clean pass. You put that ball back in the hole. You want it on the water. Wilkinson looking for an outlet. Finds it in Wong. Back out to Big Ed on top. A European player would shoot that ball into the hole for the foul. Oh, a quick bar shot by Maretzki and Cockett with the follow. That's 1-0 Pono. Pono getting a myriad of opportunities here at the beginning of the game. Iolani looking a bit distraught already. They got to put it into their big man in the hole. Hope he can do something this afternoon. Schatz with the ball again up on top, being pressured heavily by Cockett. Having trouble maneuvering the ball. They throw it over to number three, that's Flagg. He's fouled. They got Anderson open in the hole, they finally get it in there. He's got an open shot, he blows it in.
Nice hole shot by Dean Anderson. Tying the score, for the Iolani one.
It's one up here. Eddie Weldon had his hands tied a bit. Not much he could do with that. Ball was thrown in the hole. Anderson seemed to be holding him a bit. Ref didn't see it. That's the way it goes in water polo. It's one up. Now Eddie gearing up, rearing back up court. Sees Wong in the hole. Gets it down there. Got a man with inside water. That's Stevenson. They call him for an offensive. Mystery call by Mr. Referee. None other than the Pono alumnus, Charles Bishop Dwight III. That'll be Armstrong taking the ball out. He gets it over to Flagg. Flagg working it over to. Okay, that's number 10. Anderson in the hole again. This time he's fouled correctly. He's looking for a free man, not too many. One wisely fouls outside, break the three foul sequence in the hole. There's another foul in the hole. Iolani looking for some movement, can't find much. That's an underwater call, the ball goes underwater while the offensive man has his hand on it. That's a turnover. Wilkinson ball up quickly, finds Maretzki on the wing. They got Stevenson open for a cross, but he doesn't see him. He blows it in himself. Maretzki not wasting any time. Nothing fancy. Just straight heat into the back of the cage, and that makes it Punahou 2-1. Iolani still very much in the game. It's early when it's the first quarter in water polo. It's number two for Iolani. Schatz with the ball. He dumps it over to number 10. That's Faulkner. In relation to James, I don't know. Flagg in trouble. Gets it over to the wing. They want Anderson in the hole. That was an offensive. Called the other way. Wilkinson up with the steal. That's where a goalie's supposed to be. Sees that pass coming into a man inside. He wants to get up and get ready for a steal. Cockett's way free on the other side. Maretzki's looking to shoot again. They're splashing. Oh, a little too casual with the ball. Oh, but a quick pass across the middle to Stevenson. It makes a score Pono 3-1.
Number four.
Iolani's got to be careful here. They could be blown out if they're not.
What?
A nice cross-court pass.
They're not real real tough here. Faulkner controls over to number 11. Wait a minute. Anderson's number 11 this afternoon. Weldon with a near steal up top. They throw it in the hole. There's a foul there on number 10. Faulkner. Nice stop by Wilkinson. Stayed low, got the save. Maretzki, a common figure coming down the break. Holds it up. They want to set up this time. Into Cockett in the hole. There's one foul. There's a driver up top in the person of Weldon. Oh! Wong with a quick lefty from the side. Armstrong's got to be wondering how much more of this he wants to take. It's now 4-1.
2:25.
Iolani needs a timeout. They don't take it. Ball is in play. Oh, Pono could have an easy underwater steal right there, but Anderson controls up top for Iolani. Gets it over to number 2. That's Schatz. Schatz pressured heavily by Twigg-Smith. Weldon with a good D up top. That's Punahou defense. There's a weak shot in the hole. Wilkinson doesn't have to do much but pluck it out of the water and get it out to Wong on the break. Stevenson's free for a quick one inside. Didn't have time to handle it too well. Just directed at the goal. Wasn't enough. Armstrong up with it. Nice outlet out to number 2. That shot's for Iolani. He comes up court. Thinks he sees a hole, man, but decides to control it. Anderson finally gets his big body down into the hole. He gets a foul. He's controlling it, looking for an outlet. Not much driving going on for Iolani. Decides to send it back up top to Faulkner. Faulkner's foul, that breaks the sequence. He wants to get it back into Anderson, and he does. There's another foul. Anderson controlling, looking for a pass. Iolani needs some driving down the middle. They're not getting it. Time is running down for Iolani here. They've got another nice steal by Stevenson. Fronted his man after the foul. Textbook defense. Oh, the pass a little long to Weldon. Weldon's got those long arms and not that long. Ted Armstrong, Teddy, ladies and gentlemen, his Iolani teammates. Looking for that familiar wing and that of Schatz.
Both ends of the pool here.
Punahou relentless with the D. This looks like 1973, 1974 Punahou defense. I haven't seen defense like this in a long time. Pressure all around the court. Anderson finally gets something in the hole. They call a hook, offensive foul on Anderson. He's not getting back on defense, and Pono has another break. Cockett controls it. There's a man wide open on the far side. Cockett's fouled, not much he can do. Weldon's finally free. Oh, a swing shot from the side. From Maretzki, more concentration needed on that shot. A little too casual. Armstrong controls. That's number 2, Schatz with the ball in the wing again. They like to work it down the wing to him. Fortunately, he's having a little trouble getting in the hole this afternoon.
No.
Okay. Tilt your camera down.
Throws it in the chain. Oh! Excuse me, Anderson with the rare back, and Wilson, another save.
Nice block by Pat Wilkinson on the shot attempt by Dean Anderson. Iolani takes possession on a corner throw.
Haven't seen Wilkinson in a few months. It looks like he's really playing well this afternoon. Staying low. You goalies, you want to stay down low the last possible second. Schatt gets it in the hole to Anderson again. Anderson wrestling. Wong with a nice finesse move on his man. Pono on the steal once again. Time running down in the quarter. That's the end of the first quarter. Your score, Punahou 1. Punahou 4, Iolani 1.
4-1.
Iolani's got some talking to do here in the first quarter. Apparently, Punahou's confidence was very much. Not much of a factor here in the first quarter. They were confident. They had a reason to be confident.
But either if you don't have a good attempt, then don't force it, because you're starting to force them. Okay?
You've done two or three turnovers that could be goals from a nice counterattack. Okay? So if you have it, you take it. If you don't, you've got to
be able to have the patience to slow down.
Yeah, defense, you guys, turn the clock. You want the 35 to run, so don't be fouling out on the perimeter unless you got to do it to break the sequence. All right? Now, Dean already has said, my ball, stop the ball. That one right there. Okay? One, how do you get the first goal?
He's going to hold there.
Okay, all I'm saying is, you guys, just be cool with what's going on defense. Okay? Other than that, you guys, you're doing a great job.
Once the ball goes into the whole forward,
set it up, run some
crossovers,
run some good kicks that way, do a good counterattack, but don't force the ball.
The ball had a couple forced shots.
Other than that, you guys, I think they're playing a nice job, nice controls up. They've had the ball more than we have because we counterattacked. You come out from that.
Then he will be kicked out of the game.
No, I'm not following weak. Following weak. He's taking me in front of him.
He's grabbing my shoe. I'm
going to stick my hands up and go down.
You just got to maybe either stay off. He starts to put his arm back.
If I made it,
push his arm up. Push his arm up or something, you know. Just don't let him get the leverage.
I mean, maybe I'm not. Do those look like fouls?
No, I know. I think it's fine. I just, you know, like the last few drops, he didn't be able to shoot the ball. Well, no, he said, you know, my ball.
Once again, the digital clock,
if he starts to do it,
the 35-second shot clock.
They just press his arm up or switch off the photo. Yeah, you guys, line up another end now. Come on now, keep on
the counter. If they do not take a shot attempt, the ball is turned over to the other team. The clock is reset after a shot attempt. And also, if a man is kicked out, it's reset to 35 seconds.
Pono players now lining up. Instead of swimming down the other end, they're walking down. A little display for the audience here. Why not when you're winning?
Or when the ball's not in play, when an offensive player has an advantage and gets pulled back from behind, that is potentially going to be a kick-out side foul. Kick-outs are for 30-second duration for the man when a team has to play a man down.
Iolani's needs a little emotion here. Their cheerleaders are trying to get them up. To little avail so far. They need one hell of a game from Armstrong to stay in this contest. He's had a couple nice saves so far. Let's see what happens. Referees lining the teams up. And we're underway here in the second quarter. Iolani not even going for the sprint this time. Why waste your energy when you're not going to get it anyway, I suppose. Stevenson on top for Pono. Cockett setting once again. Cockett looking for the shot, doesn't have it. Controls, looking around for a free man. Two drivers coming through, nothing so far. A little loopy shot by Maretzki trying to finesse the ball in. Armstrong deals it out to number 5 for Iolani. That's Brown. Brown's pressured heavily against the wall. He gets it over to number 10. That's Faulkner. Faulkner looking for a man. Got Anderson in the hole. A semi-drive by number 6 for Iolani. Number 2 puts it back in the hole. That's two fouls for Iolani. Finally getting something started. Anderson lays out. They don't see him. Wilkinson with a fine save. Never catch the ball when you're a goalie. Always try to block the ball in front of you.
And Punahou had to switch their defensive players.
Wong hustling down. Fouled on the head by number 3 for Iolani. That's Flagg. He gets it in. Stevenson setting now. Cockett moving in there. He's fouled. Punahou needs some movement. Not getting it. Wong controlling outside. Back in for two holes. Two hole fouls. They need a switch. You have to switch on the second foul in the hole. Along with the cross court. Maretzki's going to try again. This time he doesn't make any mistakes and the ball goes in the left-hand side. Not much Armstrong could do there. Any one of 3 Pono players could have taken that shot.
Mark Maretzki.
Score is now 5-1 in favor of Pono. Iolani's got to make something happen.
Maretzki's second goal. That goal came as a result of two consecutive fouls in the hole. The Iolani players were switching their defensive man, which left Mark Maretzki open for an outside shot.
Maretzki handling the ball. He's number six. An offensive foul. I believe that's on Anderson. I don't know how many he has. That could be his second. If he's gone in this game, if you get three major fouls, you're ejected from the game. Substitute may come in, but I fear if Iolani loses Anderson, this utter rout could turn into a devastation. Anderson controlling once again in the hole. It's number two for Iolani. Schatz trying to make things happen up top. He's being guarded heavily by... Now Cockett's talking to him. That's two for Anderson in the hole. No one's complimenting him. Here comes Brown. Oh, Brown's got the ball stolen. Weldon with a good defensive play to tip the ball over to Wilkinson. Punahou in control. Wong's on the break. We got an offensive foul on the far side. Coach Smith with a little, with a few words to say to Fossey, the referee. Fossey ignores him. Oh, now he shakes his head in agreement, but what can he say? The call has been made.
Coach Ken Smith over there is yelling about that offensive
Anderson
foul.
In the hole. He's looking for somebody. He's not getting much help. He finally does. Anderson being harassed. Defensive player touched the ball. The ball is live, and the shot opportunity was there. He muffed it right in front of Wilkinson. Could have put Iolani back in the game, but so it goes. Into Cockett in the hole for Punahou. No one is guarding Wong up top. He gets the ball and just blows it in. It's the old, I got him, you can have him, I don't want him, you take him by Iolani. Turns into a goal for Punahou, and it's 6-1. Here comes a substitution for Punahou finally.
A goal scored by Peter Wong, nice pass from Matt Cockett.
Number three for Punahou now in the game. Unfortunately, my roster sheet has been taken from me by one of the boys downstairs, so I might not know all the names, but pardon me, it's been a long day. Wong with the steal over to Wilkinson. Wilkinson's got to feel pretty good right now. He's got about four or five saves under his belt. Things are looking good for his team. He's going to enjoy this afternoon. Cockett with the El Rolo, but the ball is tipped by Iolani. Punahou will get it back on the two-yard line. Oh, these are Punahou cheerleaders, I am told. I didn't know that. Wong looking for a muscle shot in the hole, doesn't get a quick release back out to Cockett. Cockett's guard should have been right on him to cancel that foul, but... Oh, Stevenson with a merciful look at Armstrong, holds up. Oh, Weldon, a high corner shot that went in just in the corner. That's a world-class shot. Not much a goalie can do to stop that. He's got the long arms and the high release. So Eddie Weldon, the big senior, finally registers in the upper top corner. And this, my friends, is turning into a devastation here at 7-1. It's not even halftime. Iolani's got to get something together. They look a little distraught, and why not? Okay, Anderson, I'll think about shooting from half court, but wisely. Thinks not. And I've got my Punahou roster back, so some names will be. Oh, a fine steal by Stevenson. Pick the pocket of, that would be number six for Iolani. None other than Van. Stevenson with the ball again. Tries a little off the water shot. Nice shot, hit the top bar. But that's a nice shot. Now Armstrong clearing the ball out to the side. Doing what a goalie should do, get the ball out of there. Swim it out of there, get away from bodies. Now that's Van with the ball again. Oh, he does a little muscle play. Inder Anderson, the big hole man. He's a good setter. Iolani's got to be happy with his setting. But Eddie Weldon, who's known for his pressure defense, comes up with yet another steal. He goes down on the break. What a hustler. Stevenson controlling. There's Weldon. Oh, couldn't handle the tight rope pass from Stevenson, but he's going to get the ball back again. He's fouled. Okay, Pono should just plain old set it up here. Work a play into Wong in the hole. He's fouled. Maretzki could have shot there, thought not. And out to Stevenson. He's going to wing it. Oh, they're looking for that high corner on Armstrong, that high right-hand corner. Oh, high RB, nice feed by Maretzki. Stevenson blows it over Armstrong's shoulder. And Armstrong's got to be wondering right now what he can do to stop these open Punahou players from coming right down his throat. Not a pretty position for a goalkeeper to be in. Being a former goalkeeper myself, I know what it's like. If you're Armstrong, it's not the kind of evening where you take the rest of your players out to dinner, believe me. Van is out of the game for Iolani. Number four is in, Yamada. They try a high shot, no avail. Stevenson calling for the ball from the goal judge. He gets the ball, he has it up high. That's where a goalie should do. Keep that ball up high so your players down court can see it. Oh, a feed into the hole. I believe that was to number seven for Punahou, just in the game. That's Shipman. An errant pass, it bounced off his head. That was a near goal, as a matter of fact, but number 12 for Iolani gets it into number 11, Anderson. Anderson thinking backhand, doesn't have time to pull that maneuver. So he decides to just hang on for a while. Number 12, Oblo is in the game for Iolani. Yamada up high. Ooh, nice little shot. Wilkinson staying low, getting two hands on it, deflects it out of bounds. Wilkinson's really got to be pleased with his play this afternoon. He's having himself a nice little game. That's Faulkner with the ball over to the wing. Gets it in Anderson. Looking for Brown. Can't get him. Yamada tied up by Stevenson. He's got his hands full with Stevenson. Is that the end of the second quarter? I believe it is. That was number nine. That was Mike Sheehan in the end of the second quarter there for Punahou. Getting a little action in before halftime.
With two goals. Matt Cockett has one goal. Mark Maretzki has two goals. Peter Wong.
Well, Punahou's sitting pretty free, Iolani.
And Eddie Weldon with one goal.
They either have a lot to say at halftime or nothing to say at halftime. It depends.
Hey, you guys, sit down here for a minute.
Even though the score may not indicate it, you have two excellent water polo teams in the pool. Give you an idea of how good Punahou is this year. A lot of coaches and water polo so-called experts would rate them among the top three teams in the nation this year. This summer they played in the Hawaiian Invitational Tournament and beat such water polo powerhouses as USC's college freshman team, Newport Harbor High School, which is currently one of the best Southern California high school teams.
Okay, guys.
Could legitimately lay claim as being as good as any high school team in the nation this year.
All right, well, let's don't keep listening to that, you guys. Play well, but don't listen to what people are saying about you. Okay, now, first of all, we're still, sometimes you're rushing a little bit too much. As far as you come down, I know, you know, you're hungry to score, but you got to be able to go hard and then be able to hold off just a little bit. You know, when do you have it and when is it better to hold off? All right? Other than that, you know, your defense scares me a little bit. Dean still scares me. I know he's going to score out of the hole on you. I think you just got to respect him a little bit more. I don't want you dropping off. Now, as the game goes on, you get tired, so you don't put pressure on their outside guys, which makes it easier to throw it to Dean, makes it easier for him to get you with two fouls or to wheel you a little bit in the hole. So get up on guys and use the fouls just like you're doing and then counterattack out of there. You're doing a real nice job. The only thing I think you could also do a little bit better job on is talking to each other. Okay, but other than that, I think you guys are playing a real nice game, good shot selection, and you're putting the ball in.
pretty good percentage, I would think. Now let's go back with your starters. Okay? Starters, you line up which end? This end, right? Okay? Mike Pfeffer! Pfeffer! Mike, we need that ball!
Stop and look at me like that.
Okay.
Split right.
Okay. Yeah. That one last one in the court, that was way over the goal and he still touched it.
I know
it's better to be safe than sorry, but you gotta know when you.
I know, but you gotta block it from now on.
Yeah, I'd rather you know half of it. If your hand is that high above the goal.
Well, I wasn't sure quite how far out I was, and I just
right. I'd rather have him try again.
I know. All right.
I'm going to take any chance of having it, hit the back corner, hit the back of my head, and go in, or something like that.
Okay, now, we're going to check again on Cloud. You should have two CBG on both of them, but I think they only wrote one down. Yeah, I know, but I think he called two, but I think they only wrote one down.
First one down, somebody else.
First one down, Devin?
First one, no, that was you.
That's the other person, the second one.
No, second one, Devin.
There's one right down here, yeah.
Corner. Okay, called one on you down here. Yeah, but it was a nice release. That was a good little
one. One wasn't.
Yeah, but in.
No, wait, but it was going right there.
It's going dry.
Just right here. All right. Hey. Well, you drove back door on the deep wing, and they called
it a stud right here.
Here's Stevie's interpretation of the offense. This is legal. You can stop someone. You can hook and dry. You can do any of that. It's all, according to him, the same thing as checking like this, and the same thing as saying like that. So they're gonna let them hook the dries on you guys.
There's guys like Kale, Flagg, and he's just going.
Well, again, all right. You got to know what's going to happen.
You just got to drive wide. Drive wider on the guy. So, again, don't justify. Don't give him a chance to justify.
You've got one. Now you've got two.
Wait, can I talk to DB for a second?
What two do I have?
Well, I'm going to go ask Fosse because.
Two,
right? Do you know?
Do I have any?
I wonder when they put him
in. Two?
That's David Hale giving a few instructions to Maretzki for Punahou. Okay, here comes some. What are these, co-eds? No, these are Punahou track guys with bags on their heads, I believe. Just a bit early for Halloween, but it is Friday. The weekend's on its way. Let me give you a rundown of the Iolani players once again. That's Armstrong in the goal. Number two is Schatz. Three, Flagg. Four, Yamada. Five is Brown. Six is Van. Number nine is Upoko. Pardon the pronunciation if that's wrong. Number eight is Gusukama. Okay. Number nine, Fukuoka. 10, Faulkner. 11, Anderson. 12, is this right? Oblo. For Punahou this afternoon, once again, it's a man who's having a nice little contest, a little grin on his face at this time. Who can blame him? Pat Wilkinson in the cage, number one. Buck Giles, is he just a freshman? I don't know. I think so. He's number two. He should see some action later on. Jacob Schatz, number three, who came in the game earlier for Punahou, who, pardon my... Once again, they sprint to the four-yard line, then let up. Oh, no, they're going for it this time. Stevenson with little amusement on his face controls the ball. That's big Edward Weldon controlling for Punahou. Maybe we'll see his brother Jeff this afternoon. Cockett in the hole, strong arming the ball. Maretzki's free, coming inside. It's a crossover drive. Oh, and we have an ejection here for Iolani. No one seems to be leaving. Oh no, that's Anderson out of the game for Pono. Twigg-Smith with a nice bar shot into the goal. Anderson's back in the game. Now if I, my scorekeeper doesn't fail me here, I think that's three major fouls on Anderson. The ref doesn't seem to notice, neither does the scoreboard. Score person doesn't seem to take any notice to that. Apparently my scorekeeper has deceived me. Anderson is still in the game. Boy, do they need him. Iolani down on offense. They get a lot of driving, too many drives at once. Big Ed Weldon with the steal. Now that was a case of too many drivers. First half, they weren't driving enough. Second half, they're clogging it up in the middle with too many people driving. Maretzki motoring down for Pono. He just has a mind to shoot right now. Oh, a little lob. Tried to get cute. Didn't pay off. Maybe showing a little mercy for goalie Armstrong for Iolani. Hey, Armstrong can hold his own. You put a good team in front of Armstrong, I bet he could do a pretty good job. But that may not be the case this afternoon. Okay, Iolani coming down again. They got their hands full now. It's panic time. Punahou relentless on the D. That's Punahou defense. Never give an inch. Never give an inch. There's Ed Weldon with what could be his third steal here in the third quarter. He's everywhere. Those long arms, they help in water polo, I'll tell you that. Stevenson controlling it on the far wing. He gets it inside, throws it inside past the Cockett. Tosses a little lob. That went in. Maretzki pushed it in further, but I believe that was also... That goal will be credited to Cockett. And Punahou hits double figures in the scoring column. It's 10-1. So Anderson sitting on the ball at half. Throws it down. He's their workhorse. He's their mother load. He's going to go set him the hole. He does a nice job, like I said before. He gets that hole set. If they could only get the ball into him. Little unnecessary pressure outside by Maretzki. Better be over-aggressive than under-aggressive, I guess. Over to Brown on the far side. He's got a mind to shoot it from there, but I guess the sun was in his eyes. That's number two, Schatz getting the hole. Anderson desperately trying to get something at the goal. Throws a sort of weak hook shot. Gee, if they had another big kid like Anderson, they could be trouble. A quick cross court to Weldon by Maretzki. Doesn't produce much. That's number four for Punahou now in the game. Oh, that's Scott Stevenson. I thought that was someone else. You might be seeing a lot of new faces in the pool for Punahou in a couple minutes here. Now Anderson's way trapped out on the wing there for Iolani. That's not where he wants to be, no sir. They don't have a whole set. They don't have much going here. I think they need a timeout. If I was Anderson, I'd shoot from there. Whoa. That's number two. Schatz deciding to do something about the problem on offense for Iolani. He'll take the hole himself. He has nowhere to go. Wilkinson with a near steal there. That's where the goalie wants to be when that hole man. Ball, Wong flipped it over to Cockett, caught up. Cockett put up a nice shot, but Armstrong right there. Nice save by the, not sure if he's a junior or a senior. Armstrong with a nice save in the goal for Iolani. Okay, Anderson back in his place, the hole for Iolani. He gets it out to Schatz. Schatz is fouled, wisely so by Weldon. Iolani needs some movement. They're sitting low in the water. That's what you don't want to do in water polo. Stevenson with a little swift maneuver there on Anderson. The hole doesn't pay off. Anderson gets the foul. Anderson dumps it again. There's not much he can do. I'd hardly think you want to be dumping the ball at this point. You're 9 points down. It's time to do something. Cockett butchered in the hole. Little extracurricular. Coach Chaney for Iolani, complaining of the physical play in the hole. Weldon just bears up and shoots it. Armstrong collects it. Low left corner. And a little extracurricular at half court. That'll be an injection on Iolani player. I believe that would be number, is that Anderson number 11? Maybe showing a little sign of frustration. I believe it is. He's had a long afternoon. Who can blame him? Maretzki almost in the goal. Flips it over to Wong. Wong dumps it in. Now it's, is the scorekeeper fell asleep over there? I think it's a 12-1, but he says it's 11-1, and I'll go by his calculations. Looks like a mass exodus by the Punahou starting six. We got a host of new faces in there. Let me give you a rundown of who those are. That'll be number seven, Shipman. Pat Shipman, number seven. That's number nine, Mike Sheehan. Well, not mass substitution. We got Jacob. We got a steal by Jacob. Little action down in the far corner. Mike Sheehan getting beat on a little bit over there. Over to number 12. That's Wong setting now. Oh, Shipman's wide open. He needs an injection. Doesn't get it. Out to number three for Punahou. That's Jacob Schatz. He puts up a shot. Armstrong collects it. Armstrong starting to play well now. Oh, what a move by Anderson. Number 11 for Iolani. A little spin. A little spin play with a ball buttercupped in his arm, and he got free, but he didn't get the shot off. Iolani crying for an ejection there, to no avail. Aaron Chaney, the coach for Iolani, doing the St. Vitus dance on the sidelines. He's irate, he's livid. He wants some kickouts by the Iolani players. He's not getting paid off. Anderson controlling in the hole. He gets it back in. That's two fouls, one more. Oh, but a bad pass, and Shipman heads up play. Flicks it back to Wilkinson, who's gonna get pressured by Anderson. Anderson doesn't want to swim back down the pool. He'll go for the steal here, but Shipman collects it and brings it down court. He flips it over to number 12 for Punahou. That's Neil Kaneshiro. Kaneshiro is dumped. He was butchered in front of the hole, and he got an injection. Good play by Neil. That's on number three, Flagg. A cheapy shot tried on Armstrong that didn't go. There's 30 seconds left in the quarter, and Armstrong's had four or five great saves here at the end of the third quarter. And he's got to feel a little bit better now. He's getting his shots. He's getting his stops this afternoon. But he doesn't have much defense to work with. That's number two for Iolani. That's Schatz setting hole. Anderson's got to be tired. That's number six for Iolani. That's Van with a foul. Collecting a foul. And number 12, Oblow is in the game. He can't do much with it, so he passes it over to number seven. Upoko.
35
Upoko tries to flip it down court, but that's the end of the third quarter. And Punahou's got 11-1 lead, and it's trouble city for Iolani.
Score right now is Punahou 11, Iolani 1. Scoring for Punahou, Scott Stevenson has 2 goals. Matt Cockett has 1 goal. Mark
well,
has
you got to think the crowd might be.
Mike Twigg-Smith has 1 goal. Peter Wong has 3 goals. Eddie Weldon has 1 goal. And Dean Anderson has the Iolani 1 goal.
Play's a good body, man. That's your for play flat.
So what, Mark, are you out? What? Are you red flag or?
No.
So foolish, they just go like this. And you, what do? You stop and they're holding you. You were right in front of them. You're like this, the ball comes, you swim on here, and I'm like, the ball comes, I go like, wow, like this.
Everybody else
for a number of these players, this will be their last ILH.
You guys are out.
Quote unquote starting lineup. The seniors are Scott Stevenson, Matt Cockett, Mark Maretzki, Mike Twigg-Smith, Peter Wong, and Eddie Weldon.
Yeah, I might be wrong.
I believe you.
Underway here. It's got to be a long afternoon for Iolani. They probably haven't been beaten like this in a long, long, long time. Let me correct myself. I think they were beaten 11-3 earlier this year. Anyway, Stevenson controls the fourth and final sprint for Pono. He dumps it back off to Shipman. Now we have number 14 for Pono in the game, whose cap was not listed on the roster. Some kind of off speed stuff was thrown in the goal and went on Armstrong. That'll fool a goalie sometimes, that off speed stuff. They're expecting the hard heat and you come up with a soft floater. It sits on a line, it'll go. Okay, Iolani down on offense now. That'll be Anderson in the hole. He gets two balls, he only needs one.
Block wide. We're clear. Iolani regains
possession. Iolani not doing a lot of substituting in this game. They're sticking with their horses. Anderson controlling, looking around, sees a driver in that of number 10. That's Faulkner. Oh, Punahou ejection. Jeff Matsumoto getting the escort service out of the pool. Anderson with some hard heat, and Wilkinson comes up with a big save. Wilkinson's had himself an afternoon. Anderson tries again. This time he finds the top corner bar, and he's got to be a frustrated individual. Wilkinson really turning in an effort this afternoon. I guess he needs that big crowd to put on a show. Wilkinson with yet another save.
Blocked again by Pat Wilkinson.
That was number 10 who took the shot for Iolani. That was Faulkner. And Wilkinson has got to feel like $1 million. He's doing it all. That's number 5 for Iolani. That's Brown. Good little passer. Gets it in the hole to Anderson. Number 2, Schatz, he's been working, but he hasn't been paid off too much. That Pono defense is pretty stringent. Now Anderson, he's just going to sit and wait for something. He waits for Brown to throw it back, but this time Brown doesn't make a good pass, and Stevenson comes up with the ball. They got a 3-on-2 coming down the middle. That's Jeff Matsumoto getting a little extracurricular on the outside. Stevenson's still free in the middle. They decide to hold it up, and why not? Let's work the ball here, fellas, says number 5, Cockett, as he turns and tries to shoot.
That shot was taken after the foul was committed.
Punahou with a foul inside the hole. And Armstrong's not going to get the ball as it floats back into the goal. He's not going to let Punahou save any of their energy. Stevenson decides to just clear it out. A lot of movement going on in that hole. Cockett's got Brown, who's doesn't match up well in the size department to Cockett guarding him. Armstrong with a nice little move out of the goal to steal the ball. That's what you got to do in the, when you're in the goal. See some confusion in that ball right in front of you. Get it out of there. Don't wait for anything bad to happen. Anderson's got a little trouble controlling. And he's getting hammered inside the hole, but nothing comes of it. And referee Fosse decides to give it to none other than Punahou. Could have called it either way there. Most referees would have given it to Iolani, seeing how they're 11 points down, but hey, that's the way it goes. Shipman. Cockett set hole all afternoon. He's in fine shape. You gotta be in good shape to play this game. Oh, Cockett's been looking for that hole shot all afternoon, but he doesn't get it this time. He's not gonna get a lot of payoffs from the ref at this point in the game. Now here's Brown, the man they like to bring it down for Iolani. He pops it back out to number 10. That's Faulkner, I hope. Into Anderson, the hole, little headbutt going on. Anderson doesn't have anybody to throw it to. Finally, he finds number 12. Number 12 is Oblo. Anderson's got the ball back again in the hole. Brown's trying to do something. He's got, oh, that Pono defense is awesome at this point. Anderson giving the goalie a little shove as he swims by, but who can blame him? The goalie's been shutting him down all afternoon. That's Wilkinson. Oh, Wilkinson with another save. He's picking daisies now. Hey, it gets easier as the game goes on. Oh, Armstrong with a nice little one-on-nobody save on Stevenson. Stevenson tried to get a little cute. Anderson's not about, Armstrong, excuse me, not about to be want to be embarrassed anymore this afternoon. And he hasn't been embarrassed. He's played well. He's played a good ball game. He just hasn't had that good D in front of him to help him out. He's had a host of saves.
You guys are going in now.
As he shakes hands with Wilkinson at half court. What could be the final timeout of the game.
When you little guys, get Dean, somebody else, help out, drop off from on top. Okay? All right?
What do you say now if you're the coach of Iolani? The bus leaves at 5? I don't know what you say. You just play as hard as you can until the game's over. So Punahou, who looks like they have this game well in hand, will be the ILH champions for 1984.
If Iolani wins, then we'll be a playoff.
I believe Punahou has won the last, let me see. I graduated in 70, we've won every year since 74. Either 73 or 74. Punahou has won every year, except for one, I believe. I think that was 2 years ago when Iolani won a playoff championship up at the University of Hawaii pool. Well, enough histrionics. We're about to get underway with the final 2 minutes and 20 seconds of this contest. The players assume their positions in the field. And we're ready to get underway. A few shadows being cast here on Chris Hemeter Fieldhouse. The sun is beginning to go down. I don't think we'll have utter darkness for a junior varsity game, but the way those games go sometimes it helps the players not to see. Anyway, back to action. Okay, we got the youngsters in. That's Jeff Weldon holding the ball for Punahou. He dumps it into Peter Wong in a hole. We got Buck Giles out on top now, who's also a new face in this afternoon's contest. And we got a goal, believe it or not, by
Iolani.
two things were obstructing my view. That might have been Neil Kaneshiro or Peter Wong scoring. I see Neil with a little grin on the face. He could have been the one. That was a quick directional into the goal.
Number 12, Neil Kaneshiro.
So here we go. Let's see if Iolani can put up put up a marker here in the last 2 minutes of the game. A lot of driving going on. Oh, a possible shot opportunity by, was that Oblo? I believe so. But no go for Oblo, and it's out to number 9, Fukuoka. Oh, they've been trying grass shots all afternoon on Wilkinson. I don't think you want to throw him on the grass to Wilkinson. He's eating them up this afternoon. When I say on the grass, I mean skip shots on the water. Anderson with a nice little defensive tip up top against Wong. He's grossing Wong. He's got to be a little frustrated. Who can blame him? Over to the young kid, Weldon. Weldon's being pressured by Brown. He gets it over the other youngster. Oh, a little inexperienced there. They're trying to work the ball. They don't realize the 35-second clock's grinding to a halt. But that's the kind of mistakes you like to see kids make when they're trying hard. Okay, that's number 8 with a nice little errant pass for Iolani. That's Gusukama. He had his man. He threw the ball to him. His man moved. I guess that wasn't his fault. It was the guy who moved. But anyway, Wong and Anderson doing a slow dance in the hole. He gets it over Kaneshiro. Kaneshiro tries again to get a shot off. He's hammered in front of the goal. He got a shot off. A nice little stop by Armstrong. Kaneshiro's going to try again. He's another block by Armstrong. And Armstrong's not giving any quarter here at the end of the game.
Both of these excellent goalies, Ted Armstrong for Iolani and Pat Wilkinson.
Coach Ramsey of Kamehameha said a good thing there. Two good goalies, both ends of the pool. And they're both juniors. They're playing this well this year. It's going to be something next year. Probably 0-0. Maybe not. Okay, is that David Hong in the game for Punahou? Yes! Flips over to Wong, who rifles a quick shot. A great shot right past Armstrong into the corner. And Punahou is not letting up.
Nice goal. Nice score by number 11, Peter Wong.
I think we've got a record shellacking in the making here. My eyes don't deceive me. I think the pretty little co-ed on the scoreboard whose parts are blocking my view has just put up a 14-1 register up on the scoreboard, and I believe that is a record. Four blowouts in a water polo game. I may be wrong, I probably am. But I don't got a record book here to check on. Oh, a great opportunity by number 11 by... Was that Anderson? No, that was number 10. Faulkner with a great shot. Hit the bar, curled out. Wilkinson's a lucky man on that one. Oh. I think Wong just tried a three-quarter length shot. Anderson falls with a half-court shot. It's garbage time here at Punahou. Why not? There's 10 seconds left. Kaneshiro thinking shot. No, he's going to throw it to number 11, Peter Wong. Tries a little lob. Armstrong's going to flip it down. Now, if that ball had gone in, Armstrong tried to throw it in the goal. That wouldn't have counted. Iolani a bit distraught. But somewhat relieved, I might imagine. So you have it here. At Chris, what is this, B. Hemeter Fieldhouse? Punahou 14, Iolani 1. Stay tuned for Junior Varsity.
Started in 1973 when Coach Smith came to Punahou. Only broken in 1972 by Coach Chaney and Iolani team. Hey, best of luck to all the graduating seniors.
Legend
begins.
Iolani, good game.
One, two, three.
Iolani, good game.
We gotta go volleyball, volleyball.
No, volleyball.
Volleyball.
Okay. Volleyball.